for Google Maps. Basically, this needs a projector, but it's not there in place. So I'm just showing it to you in my laptop. Now coming up, what a heat map is actually. Heat map is just anything in a matrix format, values in a matrix format, and you represent each value with a distinct or a different color. So this is a heat map. It is applicable to any kind of information, and it also depends if you want to show this gradient of color based on the value or on the density at that coordinate. It could be something like this, and this is a matrix, and this matrix can have any sort of values, like it has green here, then it has black here, and then again here it has green, and then it has red, something like this. So these gradients, these values, or this color does not arrive, it is not necessary that it should arrive based on the value, but it could arrive based on the density of the values at that particular location. So it's up to you, up to the person who is creating the heat map, how to write the algorithm. Like, you want to consider the density or you want to consider the value at the point. So now, I will just show you different sort of heat maps. The first one is a DNA forensic array of a heat map on a solid layer. All these are the DNA values which are represented by different colors. Now this is a memory segments on a disk which is again represented in the form of heat map. The red ones is something like mostly written things, and the yellow ones are the sometimes written memory segments, and then the green ones are rarely written memory segments. Now our map, or any map, or geographical map, is again an array of latitudes and longitudes. So it's easy to put this heat map on the geographical map also. Now coming to the next thing, Google Maps. Google Maps is one of the largest map service present on the internet. Alongside with Yahoo Maps, Bing Maps, and Nokia also has its own map service. And Google Maps was most of the information today we deal with is associated to the to a location. And also, Google Maps. If you go to the programmableweb.com, it's a site where the APIs are consumed for mashup. If you go to that site, right away I can show you that Google Maps stand on the top. It is the most highly consumed web API, leaving behind Twitter, YouTube, and Flickr. I mean, it's very normal because these days mashups are very common. We consume data from different sources and create a website. That's a mashup. So in your mashup, the most important ingredient or the most inevitable ingredient is the map. So everybody wants to have their information, just not in the textual format, but also a small div element on the web page, and you just represent the map. Now, coming to the Maps JavaScript API, Google Maps was released in 2004, and Google, at that time, few developers devised a hack. They pulled the information on the Google Maps and tried to put it in their mashup. This was realized by Google, and they announced their public API in 2005, so that this could this doesn't happen anymore. And Google Maps JavaScript API is, I mean, it is very elegant API, and it can be used to do a lot of things. Like you can show the map, zoom at a particular level. You can incorporate it into your website. Okay, now Google Map JavaScript API allows you to have objects on the map surface. Any sort of objects, like markers, like polygons, polylines, and circles. So this is enabled by basically by Google Maps. Now let's say we have information associated to latitude and longitude. Now we want to represent it on the Google Maps. How do we do that? Actually, if I had a projector, I would have shown it to you. But yeah. Okay, I have created here a project I'll just not get into the details. It's a dynamic web project. It's in just as Eclipse. I started with Tomcat. Now I have downloaded the APIs, Google Map API. You cannot download it, but you can declare it in your HTML file. This is the path, http://maps.googleapis.com, maps API. And there is a variable called sensor equal to false or true. This sensor represents if your device has a GPS an ability to detect. So you make it false, and then you create a map object auto, using the API. And yeah, you create a marker objects. Marker objects has a element called position, and it takes the map. And now, if I just go here and refresh this screen, now I'm currently focused on United States. You can see there are two markers. So if the information is less, it's okay. Now what I have done is I have written a servlet which will stream out the lot of number of latitudes and longitudes for me. So I'll just show you how it looks like when there is a lot of information that has to be deal with the markers. I'll just uncomment that segment of code. This looks like this. If you have a lot of information scattered around the map, and if you want to represent it with markers, this will be the layout. To deal with this problem, what Google has provided is, it has also provided something called marker cluster. It will cluster up your markers which are nearby, and it will show it as a image, circle image. Now I will just use that. Let's see if it solves our problem. Okay, yeah. Now you can see there are different clusters of the markers. Now this little simplifies the map, information on the map. As you can see, the red ones are the ones where the values of the markers are more than 100, and the blue ones are the ones where the value is less than 10, and the yellow ones are the ones where the value is less than 100. Yeah. So, but does this give you a clear picture of your information scattered on the maps? No. It is not fine-grained, right? So here comes the heat maps. Here comes the necessity for the heat maps, where you can incorporate it into your Google Maps. Okay, now something about the heat map on Google Maps. GHeat is the name of the project where Google developed this heat maps on their Google Maps. So it's written in Python and it runs on Aspen server. Now it has been ported to different languages like .NET and Java. Now let me just take you to the Java version of it. So it is again, this is a open source project. It's hosted on GitHub, and a guy called Varun has ported it. And this is based, and this is inspired from the .NET project of the GHeat. GHeat.NET is also inspired. It is taken from the original GHeat project. And so all the imagery, like the color variations and everything on the heat map, I can show you the heat map here. Okay, all these color schemes, all these things, dots, everything is originally taken from the Google's GHeat project. So now what should we do to get started with the heat map in Java? Just go to the GitHub, download this as a zip file here. Now, once you download it, I can show you. Okay, you download it and you extract it. It will have a folder called GHeat Java Master, and it will have another folder called GHeat, and it will have a source code, and it is also having a POM XML, project object model XML. So you can build, if you have a Maven with you in your computer, you can build a jar out of it, and also you can add an entry for creation of sources. So you can create two jar files, one for just like I have created, one is for sources and the other one is for executable jar. And now you place this jar files into your Apache Tomcat, into your Eclipse project library, and also in lib folder in under Apache Tomcat, so that it is used for in runtime. Okay, now let me just go and explain you the UI of it. Here what I am doing is basically to generate a heat map out of on Google Maps. I have written a servlet which will call the project, the jar, the classes inside the jar which we have currently built. The most important class is heatmap class. It has two public methods for getting the imagery, the heatmap imagery tile. Okay, now before that, let me tell you, Google Maps is something like, I mean, when it is rendered to the user in a browser, it's again images which are divided into 256 into 256 pixel height and width. So there are a lot of such images which come and get nipped at the client side. So the image what we are going to generate for heat map should also be of the same size. So that is what I have declared here in my HTML. That is map size 256 into 256. Again coming back to the heat map class, it has so my servlet will be called 24 times. In the servlet, what it does is it calls the heatmap class, and heatmap class will take the pointers, take my information. Okay, one more thing. Here in this my heatmap servlet, I have used file data source. Currently, what I have done is I have created this latitude and longitude values in a file, and also I have associated weight to it.
Google
Hangout, share, leave my laptop there, so it will be easier for them to see. Okay, these values, what my servlet will do is, I'll show you here. Here I will just create a data source first, and again this file is also coming from the same jar file which I downloaded and just built. And this is a file data source, and I read it. I also initialize the theme manager. Theme manager, what it does, it will set up all these themes. Yes, it is also there. I'm going to cover that also. I will show the differences also. So these are the some color schemes directly downloaded from Google's Gheat project, and we have used it. And and these are the dots. Now each dot here is based on the zoom level. If you are completely zoomed off, I mean you are looking from the high level, then the dot will be very small. If you are completely zoomed in, then the dot will be bigger. So this imagery is also taken from the Google's Gheat project. Here it will construct this color scheme list and dot list. Now coming to the UI part of it, index.html. Okay, now here you can see that what I am doing is I am using a JavaScript method which I have written, get heat map, and it will contact this tile URL, that is nothing but my servlet's URL, and it will get the tiles. If there are 24 tiles loaded, it will get 24. If there are 36 tiles loaded, it will get 36 images. Now all these things of laying on the dots and everything is done in the done by the API which we downloaded just now. Now let me just take you to the UI, how it looks like. This is the same information which we just while ago took a look with markers and clusters. Now here is the information in the heat map. Now this is the fine grained view what you are looking at, but the heat map here is not generated based on the values associated to the latitude and longitude, but on the based on the density. So if you zoom into it, these pointers will disperse, and you will see a much elaborated blotch and you still zoom, keep zooming into it, it will expand. And if normal Google API in the Google API which generates the heat map in JavaScript itself is, you have to add one more variable called library is equal to visualization. In this visualization library, you have this heat map option. And let me show you how it looks like when I generate it in JavaScript. It's the same map. You cannot see the frying grain and the opacity and all those things which you can control with Java more. And Java has all these image libraries, image.io, which will write, which will render you better images in the PNG format and all those things. And also, we had an occasion where we wanted the values associated to the heat map to be displayed in different colors, color gradient. This definitely you cannot achieve with JavaScript. Yes, for rendering the easy type of heat maps, yes, it is. Yes, but you have to write all those. You have to write additional stuff with JavaScript already in place. Google's it's a Google's product, GHeap project, and it's very closely, the Java port or the .NET port is very closely related to it. You can generate such sort of image.
Question regarding the Java and JavaScript comparison essentially. So in Java, as I understood, when you zoom in, it comes back to your data.
Exactly.
It gets the data for the currently displayed data.
No, I don't do. It's a static. Once I read the data, and that is the data. But whereas in Java, as Prashant told, you can also, if it is a live streaming, you can visualize a different picture, different heat map. Whereas in JavaScript, this is not possible.
You can send the updated JSON text.
Yes, every time you can read it and then generate the heat map. Yes, we have to write that event listeners and the map zoomed in event and map zoomed out event, all those things. But here it will take care. Which areas, if you have the latitude, longitude, locations, everything like that. Thank you for being here.